Hello friends, now we are going to learning the assimilation of ammonia. The ammonia is readily available to plants either as a product of nitrogen fixation or it is available from the soil. The accumulation of free ammonia is harmful to the living cells as it affects the activity of nitrogenase enzymes. Also, it affects on energy metabolism and ETS pathway. To avoid such adverse effect, the free ammonia, whenever it is available, it is rapidly incorporated into the amino acid by ammonia assimilation. So the ammonia assimilation takes place by five different pathways that are reductive amination reaction, transamination reaction, synthesis of carbamyl phosphate, amide synthesis, and GSGO GAT cycle. So first one is reductive amination reaction. So when a glutamic acid is synthesized by direct incorporation of ammonia into alpha ketoglutaric acid by the enzyme glutamic dehydrogenase, this reaction is called reductive amination. The second reaction is transamination reaction. The transfer of amino group from one amino acid to keto acid is called transamination. It is catalyzed by a group of enzyme known as amino transferase. As such a reaction, the ammonia initially used for synthesis of glutamic acid, and it is utilized for synthesis of new amino acid. So glutamic acid plus oxaloacetic acid giving alpha ketoglutaric acids and aspartic acid. Now see here, the glutamic acid plus pyruvic acid giving alpha ketoglutaric acid and alanine. So transamination reaction takes place. Third one is synthesis of carbamyl phosphate. The third pathway of ammonia assimilation is synthesis of carbamyl phosphate. The carbamyl phosphate is then utilized in the series of reaction to synthesize amino acid arginine. So the reaction see here. Ammonia plus carbon dioxide plus ATP giving carbamyl phosphate and ADP. This carbamyl phosphate undergoes series of reaction giving the arginine. So arginine is one kind of amino acid. Next pathway is amide synthesis. When available ammonia is in a large amount, in excess, the amide synthesis takes place. Amides are the amino acids with extra amino group and therefore considered as a metabolic nitrogen reservoir. The amide synthesis requires energy and it is supplied by ATP molecules. The amides are synthesized from acidic amino acids like glutamic acid, aspartic acid. So glutamic acid plus ammonia plus ATP giving glutamine. Similar to that, aspartic acid plus ammonia plus ATP giving asparagine. So glutamine and asparagine are the amino acids. So glutamine and asparagine are the amides. So in amide synthesis, they are very important of nitrogen fixed ammonia, and it is get assimilated. The last pathway, that is GSGOGAT cycle. The ammonia produced by the nitrate reduction process is rapidly assimilated into organic compounds with the help of GS and GOGAT system. GS means glutamine synthetase and GOGAT means glutamate synthetase. Both GA, GOT and GS are the commonly found in the root and leaf cell. GS is found in the cytosol of a root cell, and in both cytosol and chloroplasts in the leaf cell. So see here, the ammonia plus glutamate is glutamic acid giving glutamine, and these are the interconvertible GS cycle and GOGAT cycle is as showing here. You can be learned in detail. Now see here the functions of amino acids. There are 22 amino acids. The amino acids are used for production of structural proteins. The amino acids are used in the synthesis of nucleotides, the purines and pyrimidines. The amino acids are used for synthesis of enzymes, proteins, hormones, and the chief function of amino acid is in the cell is the transformation and metabolism of energy, and it is also very important during the seed germination. So amino acids stored in the seed protein are hydrolyzed during the germination and later on utilized for growth and development of a plant. So this is all regarding the ammonia assimilation and the functions of amino acids. Thank you very much.